Hey guys, it's Elise. Welcome back to My Cupcake Addiction. Today we're going to be making a no-bake strawberry milkshake tart. These are amazing because, among other ingredients, these hinge on the use of strawberry milk powder, so they actually taste like a strawberry milkshake. As well as the strawberry milk powder, I've got some milk, I've got some powdered sugar, some crushed Oreo cookies, a little bit of whipping cream, some sprinkles for decorating. I've got some cream cheese and some melted butter, and I'm going to add just a touch of pink food colouring because I want mine to look really extra strawberry. For all of your measurements, quantities and conversions, you can head to the mycupcakeaddiction.com website where you can print that recipe out and save it for later. The first thing that you want to do is you want to take your melted butter and we're going to pour it over our Oreo cookies, and you're going to stir that through to make your easy no-bake crust. Particularly for these tarts, you do want to make sure that your Oreos are really nicely crushed. So normally I'd say you could crush them using a Ziploc bag, but for these, I would recommend putting them into a blender or a food processor so you get a really nice fine crumb. I'm going to be presenting these today as little mini milkshake tartlets. You could use a large 9-inch springform pan. You could use a 9 to 10-inch tart pan, but I'm going to use 6 little tiny, I think they're about 4-inch tart pans because I love the way they look when they're kind of tiny and small. Perfect. Now, once that's all the way mixed through, you want to grab your tart pans and we're going to evenly divide the mix between my 6 little mini tart pans. I'm just going to take sort of even-sized spoons and just spoon into each of the pans, and then I'll keep doing that until all of my mix has been used. All right, once it's all into your little pans, you just want to bring out your inner mud pie maker and we're just going to press it down. You do want to make sure that you're pressing it really nice up those side walls and giving it kind of a bit of a neat edge at the top. So make sure that you're really firmly pushing it down. And as you're pushing it down, you're also kind of like squeezing that mixture up the sides so that it's not all trapped on the bottom of your tart pan. So the neater you get those top edges, the neater your tarts are going to turn out overall. Now, while they're setting, and you can set them in the fridge, but it really doesn't matter here, we're going to combine our strawberry milk powder and our milk together, just like a strawberry milkshake. Give it a little stir, and then you can pour it into a larger bowl. This bowl needs to be big enough to incorporate everything, so for me, I've got quite a large bowl. The smell of strawberry milk makes me feel like I'm 5 years old again. All right, your super thick strawberry milk goes in with that powdered sugar and your cream cheese. If you're using a paste colour, now's a good time to add it. So I'm just going to pop in just a little dollop. I don't want this to be fluorescent pink, but I do just want to give it that little bit more of a kick of colour. Perfect. Using an electric mixer, we're going to mix that on high until it resembles like a creamy mousse. A very pink creamy mousse. Perfect. Once that one's all ready to go, we're going to whip the cream. So I'm using a whipping cream, which has got about a 35% milk fat. And we're going to semi-whip it. So when you semi-whip a cream, you want to make sure that it's just starting to thicken up, but that your beaters aren't necessarily leaving marks in it, because once we mix it through our pink mix, that's going to continue to whip it, and we don't want to have over-whipped cream in our finished product. All right, so when I say semi-whipped, it's not liquid anymore. It is definitely a lot thicker, but it will just slide straight off a spoon or a spatula. That's the consistency that we're going for. You want to take that mixture now and we're going to gently fold it through our strawberry mixture. And this is where we kind of continue to whip the cream a little bit. The cream's going to give not only stability to our little tarts, it's also going to give a light fluffiness that's going to really complement that strawberry milkshake flavour. As I fold that mix through, I'm using nice big sweeping strokes, and you're going to fold that all the way through till it looks like a beautiful light pink strawberry mousse. Folding it with these great big strokes also helps to keep the air in that cream. If you try to whip it too much or too hard, you can kind of knock the air out of it and you don't get as much light fluffiness. Perfect, that looks pretty delicious to me. All right, we're gonna grab our pre-prepared tart shells and we're just gonna scoop in an even amount of mixture into each one. I'm just eyeballing these, but you kind of want to put in a little bit too much rather than a little bit too little, because we're going to scrape them back, but you only get one chance at the scraping before you start to drag those brown Oreo crumbs through everything, so you want to make sure that you've got enough mix in each tart to start with. I'm going to use an offset spatula. If you don't have one of these, you can use something like a bread knife or a nice flat ruler, but I highly recommend getting one. This is one of my most used tools. So what I'm going to do is, being careful not to touch the outside edges, I'm just going to work back and forward. And then, as I'm happy that my mix has become nice and sort of even, I'm gonna start in the middle, and I'm gonna do one sweep out to one side, and one sweep out to the other. That's all you wanna do, because if you now start trying to work that back and forth, you're gonna drag Oreo cookie crumbs all through that beautiful pink top. So try to be really neat here. All right, so they might not look like much just yet, but those are your strawberry milkshake tarts ready to go in the fridge. Now, I recommend covering them with some plastic wrap or putting them in a plastic container just so that all of that creamy mixture doesn't absorb any smells or flavors that might be lurking in your fridge. One of the great things about this recipe, all those scrapings off that we've taken from the top of our tarts, someone's gonna have to look after those. You want those ones in the fridge for about an hour or two before we decorate them, and you want to keep them refrigerated right up until serving. But just before you're ready to decorate, take an additional half a cup of whipping cream and you want to whip it quite firmly, so into firm peaks. Perfect. Now, just so that you guys can see the really marked difference between a softly whipped cream and a firmly whipped cream, that is your firmly whipped cream, so it's got a lot of texture, it doesn't fall off the spoon, maybe if you give it a good shake, but you're actually going to be able to sort of scoop through that, and your spoon or your beaters will leave a nice mark in that cream. Cover that up, put it back in the fridge until we're ready to decorate. This is always the best part, this is where we get to decorate. So I've got my fully whipped cream and I've popped it in a piping bag with just a star piping nozzle. It doesn't really matter what size, but don't go too large here because these are petite little tarts and we want petite little stars of cream. So I'm gonna go all the way around the outside and I'm just gonna do literally little tiny dollops of cream or little stars. And I have removed those from those little tart pans. And the great thing about those removable bases is you can just slide the tart right out and pop the base off the bottom. Perfect. Once those ones are all done, all you need to do now is take some of your sprinkles and get the brightest, funnest coloured sprinkles you can, and we're going to sprinkle on top. Make sure you get some on the sides, make sure you get some around the edges. This kind of adds the fun factor to these, and I think the contrast of the white cream against that beautiful pale pink filling and then the sprinkles on top makes this an incredibly fun little tart. Voila! Our little strawberry milkshake tarts are done. These guys are no bake, they are super fun, and they're a really, really great twist on a classic favourite. That strawberry milk powder gives these the ultimate strawberry milkshake flavour. If you guys are not already subscribed to the My Cupcake Addiction YouTube channel, make sure you do for 2 new weekly uploads. And as always, guys, thanks very much for watching.